Okay, here we go. Pluto in Capricorn. What can I glean about Pluto in Capricorn? Well, I would say it's the most secure position for it, Pluto in Capricorn. Maybe the most predictable things that you think might happen would happen. The only thing is, if it's karmic, it could be some significant karma for those that, positive and negative. Hopefully it's positive. Of course, negative karma also helps spur you to higher thinking in some ways, but definitely Pluto in Capricorn is a good mix for karma, because it's a sextile between Pluto and between Scorpio and Capricorn is 60 degrees, so that's a sextile, so the energy is well absorbed, the karma is synthesized, so it can be taken care of in one return if it's and understood in a complete way, in a balanced way. Sometimes if karma comes in at odd angles, at squares or oppositions, it can be difficult for the soul to assess or understand what's happening. And, you know, effects of karma are sometimes, you know, mental poisons, you know, anger, whatever, that are byproducts or that are effects of karma working itself out. I'm not sure if I know anything specific to say about Pluto in Capricorn. I'm not really a personal astrologer. I mean, Linda was the master of everyday, you know, personal kind of ideas for what the planets had in store for people's own charts. I'm way more probably too abstract, and I really don't have a... My personality is not really inhabiting a lot of my soul's matrix, even though a lot of my planets are in the first house would give me an immediacy, but the real essence of my soul's journey is probably sometimes if the aura is inundated with the purple energy of the 14th chakra or the higher chakras, you don't always personalize your experience on earth. You don't really see yourself as a personality. I mean, you're free to sort of use the earth's dynamics for the soul's purpose, but it's not really a personalized integral feeling of being alive and having some kind of down-to-earth destiny. My destiny sort of feels otherworldly. I mean, art and acting and poetry and all those things, even higher mathematics, is really abstract otherworldliness. At least in today's age, most of the people probably don't, of course I can't speak for all people, but most people might not have, may feel their egos integrated in their day-to-day living. They may not have access to higher parts of the mind that take them away from their daily grind. I mean, the confused inertia of being alive on this planet and the aggravation of suffering that every person endures on some level sometimes obscures people from learning from it, because it's overpowering to them, or it brings bitterness, it brings antagonism, or it brings comparative thinking. Why me in this position? Why someone else having another karma? Well, all that is futile. You can't compare yourself with others, because the spirit, each spirit of each person is unique. So there's no comparison in spiritual experiences, but because of the diffuse and the compact energy of the earth, it creates a false scenario of people being in pain and being upset and being bickering and whatnot. I mean, people kind of get into their false acting scenarios and identify with it, but it's really not what the spirit is all about. And some avatars that come into earth, or some people that have finished their karma and have a different, a lesser, lighter karma as far as earth experience, but have access to their true origins. I mean, everyone on this planet is not from here. They're from other worlds. But some, since the universe is infinite, there's higher, lower, middle worlds. I mean, I can't assess where everyone is from, but I just know that there's so much uniqueness that it's imperative not to compare, because comparisons are only lead to mental aggravation, leads to all sorts of lower ego manipulations. You know, you get caught in the matrix. I mean, the matrix is already under the predation trauma of 400 million years ago. So add unto that a lack of awareness of what the soul's purpose is, then you've got all sorts of problems. You may not escape the matrix for thousands of lifetimes. And most people might not even know they're in a matrix. They may be asleep. But, you know, if you're aware that the rest of the universe is blissful and you really have that internalized in your soul, then when you come to Earth, your approach is different. You may not take it seriously, or it just opens up all sorts of different ways of looking at your life. And, you know, what, there's 6-8 billion lives going on. So who can tell where everyone is and who would want to compare? I mean, other than to get entangled in someone else's drama, and a lot of people are into that. That's part of the drama, is to react to other people. But I never felt like I was necessarily in my body. My soul existed outside my body, and some of the placements of the asteroids have something to do with that. But the problem with that thought, which I looked at again after I wrote to you about the asteroids being in certain signs, and the particular placement of one of mine led to the fact, or the idea, that I didn't quite inhabit the lower part of my body, because the asteroids is like a different part of the consciousness. But the problem with that is, since the asteroid belt is the effect of a trauma, a broken planet, I'm not sure I can agree with the thought that I had, I mean, that I gleaned from that. It takes on a different meaning. It might even mean that I sense the damage in the soul. So I'm not fully incarnated, because the soul doesn't wish to be enmeshed in the trauma. And if people realize there is a trauma, and if they experience trauma, well, that's the trickery of the material world fallen from the spiritual. And everyone has that problem on this earth, whether they know it or not, and maybe they don't know it, and they totally insulate themselves with all sorts of ego distractions, or just, you know, pursuit of pleasure or money or whatever anesthetize the soul, which you can do, but maybe I don't think like others think. I don't know. I mean, I don't never really compare myself to others, because I'm too absorbed with trying to navigate my own life. I don't really. It seems a waste of time to try to think of others in relation to you. I mean, you just enjoy the life you're given, and right now I've got 10 tomatoes getting ready to be picked, and we have a woodchuck chuck next door, and we enjoy feeding the birds here. We've had about 10, 9 or 10, maybe 8, 9, 10 thunderstorms last week, and we should be getting some dry sunny weather so I can finally cut the grass. So Pluto and Capricorn, I would imagine that's going to be a lot of societal difficulty, because Capricorn is the government. It's the overarching karma of the planet. I mean, Capricorn watched the crime in high places entering the solar system. Capricorn couldn't stop it, but it saw what was happening. The Sirius, the ABC, the three stars of Sirius, the sixth dimensional Sirius system, where some people think the Dogon tribe think that's where their ancestors were. The Dogon tribe is in Africa. It's possibly the black races emanate from there, but that's just a simplification. I mean, there were seven races on the planet at the beginning, and I think higher up the black races were the indigo races were the first, and then the black, and then it diffused down. The white is the absence of color, so the white was much later, and also has to do with where you're living. I mean, the sun creates a certain melatonin or some chemical when you have too much sun, and the skin over millions of years darkens. I mean, the red skins, the red Indians get red. Each race is different, so unique, that my response to people that bring up the Pardon me, just a minute. What?
Move over somewhere else.
Just a minute. Yes. Yes, I'm moving. Oh, that was Christina. I talked too much. All right, I'll go over. Yes, no problem. I talk a lot. I have my five. I'm a nonstop talker. That just what comes naturally to me, but a lot of people can't listen to me for very long because I'm very sporadic in my thinking, very in the moment. You know, I got four planets in my first house, so they're all vying for, you know, trying to express themselves in the immediacy. And then when you're talking about esoteric things, trying to jump from the esoteric world to the immediate world is really a kind of a difficult thing. It takes a lot of energy to do that. But anyway, racism. I often write people that bring up that is that, you know, why life is not a race. You're not racing around a track. You're not racing with other people and then looking in the other lane. That person's faster. That person's slower. It's just ridiculous. I mean, each race is individual, and there's no goal line here on the planet. I mean, beyond the planet is where infinity is, and you're not going to get any satisfaction with thinking your life is just, you know, racing around and comparing yourself to one another. Now, back to Pluto and Capricorn, yes, it's the entire government is being, on the deepest, profoundest level, is being looked into Pluto, the Plutonic, you know, just Pluto is just like a surgeon drill. I mean, it's like, that's what Linda would say, but like a very deep scorpion sting, the thing of penetration of the mental masculine energy, just, you know, analyzing everything on a societal level. Pluto in Capricorn is like that intense energy worldwide, and, you know, you're seeing it with, you know, dysfunctional governments and whatnot, and the manipulation, the COVID manipulation. Of course, that's an off world. I mean, to me, that's an off world ruse to siphon off DNA from the planet. Unwilling, I mean, they're turning the whole world into like drug addicts that are having needles stuck into them. To me, they're siphoning off energy to, you know, I'm sure the military industrial complex is behind that game. I mean, they're not terribly enlightened as far as Aries is not always very much enlightened. In fact, I think the planet Mars came here after the trauma. They came to police the solar system. I'm not sure if it was an altruistic reason they came, or if it was just part of the control matrix. Or if it was a control matrix, then the Uranians let them in. I don't know if Pluto was in the conspiracy or the espionage of the planet. Definitely Jupiter was not. Jupiter suffered the scar that brought out Venus, the south, that balanced the universe, the solar system. My question is whether the deliberation of the crime was meant, well, was it malefic or beneficent? Maybe some theologians would think would pose that question. Since we're in an eternal, infinite universe, I mean, the end result obviously is going to be beneficial, beatific. But the playing out of it in three-dimensional space where we're at, you know, you take opposite sides. It's evil and good. I mean, that's all this is around here. If you focus in on the evil and good, I'm kind of scattered. Tonight we had tacos, and I may have my first concert here locally, so I'm getting ready for that. I've only given three concerts my whole life, public concerts in Seattle, and that was, how many years ago was that? That was over 30 years, or 81, so 9100, yeah, more than that, 40 years about. So I haven't played in public, I mean, other than, you know, you know, making a living in, you know, clubs and whatnot, but not an actual austere concert. I mean, not that they're necessarily austere or a classical concert like that, but first time I've gone into a theater just by myself there's a reason, oh boy, I can't stand those thumping automobiles. Just, oh God, it's so oppressive. The energy that's, the electrical energy is just such a wipeout as far as a control mechanism to interrupt the brain waves, basically, of people. Quiet is such an important pursuit. If you can find a quiet space, you'll save your brain and mind and nervous system a lot of trouble. We got a lot of jumping squirrels here, woodchucks, doves, little sparrows. We got about 50 little sparrows that were born last couple months, and they fly around. Luckily, birdseed is kind of cheap, and they're just fun to watch. I mean, they get you out of the matrix, because the Pleiadians, the birds are seventh dimensional. You know, immediately you get out of the matrix when you see birds, because they're beyond the four-dimensional, the Uranian, the Zeta Reticulan, two-dimensional, the, you know, the infusion of this electrical, like, wedge of siphoning off chi, spiritual chi from the entire Earth. And the solar system's chi was stolen, is still being siphoned off. The Hindus went inward in their yogic tantra, because the outward was missing. The outward bliss had gone out of the picture 400 million years ago. So their only way of becoming sane spiritually was to go inward mantrically, and, you know, reach the inner state. But the original state of mankind was outward and inward. It was both. It was the O and the I. Adds to seven. O is the fourth letter, the fourth vowel. I is the third. So 40 and 30, they both have the zero, because sound is infinite. So the 70 angstroms of energy, which correlates to the Pleiades, there's seven stars of the Pleiades, the seventh dimension, the seven sisters, the seven arts. The Greeks, for some reason, added two. They think there's nine, so I don't know what the Greeks had going. Jesus used to love to talk to the sages in Greece. He really thought that was one of the best civilizations on the earth at the time he was walking around. Philosophers, they recognized his divinity and his mission on the planet. Pluto and Capricorn. Well, I'll tell you what, if you eat a lot of corn on the cob, they'll ground you. Capricorn contains the word corn, and it has to be the most satisfying food on the planet. Ever since the Aztecs, I mean, corn, oh my God. Fresh corn with butter. Sometimes if I feel like you don't need to eat anything else but that. Maybe some, you know, the Indians, of course, grew maize and probably just beans and vegetables. We had tacos. I'm fortunately a descendant of my family's heavy meat eaters, the Italian and the Welsh, so I haven't gotten off meat. Or I would, like Linda would say, I might fly off into the ethers. Maybe I use it to grind. I'd still like to do physical exercise and work, and I'm not sure if I tried vegetarianism for about a year or so, and it was a little bit hard on my nervous system, because, I mean, the infinite universe understands what predation is. It's just a limited scheme. I mean, the universe is not going to judge your soul's ascent by what you eat. I mean, eventually the soul's going to ascend. I mean, by 14,000 AD, the Immaculate, what I call the Immaculate Perception, will occur naturally, because the Earth system will ascend into the age of Virgo, which is the Virgin. So this idea of the Immaculate Conception, that was a higher energetic thought that Christ emanated by what the theologians of the time, maybe the Jewish leaders that were enlightened, that's what it meant on a higher esoteric level, that the Immaculate Conception is the conception of the Christ. What do they call that, New Age, the Christ, Merkaba? I'm not sure if that's the same word, but it's the Christology, the thousand-petaled lotus, the enlightened man, Da Vinci, the New Age. What worries me about the religious people is that this rapture concept, I'm not sure they understand what they're talking about, and I don't know how I would explain it to them. Most religious people that I talk to are so caught in ego dramas in the third dimension, there's no way you can... I've tried and tried to try to imagine how to explain something seventh dimensional to someone that's trapped in third dimension. And most of them think everything in the Bible is in the three-dimensional eye, where the eye is really relating to the spiritual, when the kundalini or whatever, the dove descends into the... you know, into the 14th chakra portal of the human aura, that's the I, but it's not the egoic I. Of course, it unites with the ego, and the ego and the enlightenment unite, but I'm not sure if religious people that teach that in fundamentalist organized religion Or does I don't maybe it doesn't matter that they understand it. Maybe their heart is in the right intention and it doesn't, but usually a society that argues with each other can't possibly be enlightened, because if a person was enlightened, they wouldn't need to argue. They'd be so uplifted by what they understood, like someone floating in the sky, that, well, there's nothing to argue with. I mean, the Zen religion talks about the victim and the victimizer, that if you're not in the same place, there's no conflict. It's when the victim and the victimizer get close enough that the ensuing drama of I'm right, you're wrong, you're the victim, I'm the victim, that all that negativity, positivity that's been on the planet for 400 million years starts to occur. So I hope I'm not going on too long, but I was asked to talk about Pluto in Capricorn by a very, 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 spiritual person who lives on the East Coast. See, if you're looking from the North Pole, it's the left coast. If you're looking from the equator, it's the right coast. So I'm not sure. I was watching a good lecture last night about the geological ages, which was kind of fascinating, going back before the comet, 100 million years ago. He didn't say anything about 400 million years. That's Joseph F. Goodovich. And I don't know how many other people talk about that. That was one of Linda's books. She recommended that. And there's so many other books that I have not read. I mean, I have a paucity of things I have not read. I don't have the nervous system to sit and read it. For some, I just can't calm myself down to follow the logic of sentences. I mean, I pick and choose what I will read, and sometimes, and basically, I think we learn just from other people's. I mean, telepathy will be in the ascent in the Capricorn age. I mean, everyone will be telepathic. You don't need all these gizmos for communicating. You'll just hear what people are thinking, and of course, that's in the eternal now. When you leave the planet, you ascend into that. But a lot of people have karma, or they choose karma to come back, so they keep going in and out of it. The worlds. So anyway, I don't want to take up too much time, and I'll just wait for the next time you have a question, the email, or I'll just. I've been reading a few things of Linda's. I still have her first book. It's all tattered, but it's the one that I had when I knew her in '87, and it's. I'm just amazed at how much, just in a couple sentences, how much wisdom there is. I mean, it's just, the book is just full of everything a person would need to know to become spiritually, become, to achieve an equilibrium in your spirituality. It's just, she's an amazing force for calmness. Have a good evening, and 4th of July, we'll see what, this will be the, when did it start? 1776, 124, 224, 224, are we 243 now? Oh God, that's right, the 243rd year, that's why all this conflict, 43 is war and conflict, this idea of the nation, the systematic this, the systematic that. I mean, if you want to talk about systematic, talk about cars. I mean, that's systematic racism in the sense of unnaturally racing through space. I mean, cars drive people insane just by the fact that they push people backwards. I mean, wheels do not go forward. They go backwards and propel people through space. So like car lag, jet lag, any mechanical lag wearies the spirit. So if you want to talk about, of course people suffer. There have been slavery, both races, all through having... There's slavery in business, there's slavery in ants. Everything in this world is enslaved, and it's, the chaotic, traumatic effect of the fall. I mean, there's probably not anyone that's not enslaved, except maybe an enlightened person. They're maybe enslaved to the idea that they have to. Well, no, an enlightened person has no enslavement. They don't need to inhabit that space, because it's like someone in a floating air balloon that never touches the earth. I mean, that's quite a thought. Anyway, I shall talk to everyone or no one later. It doesn't really matter. Because in the end, nothing is matter, it's spirit. Recycling? What do you mean recycling? I don't want recycling. Hello? Is that still going? Oh my God, it's still going. What a doofus brain. I'm a doofus. I'm a doofus. Why don't you stop, computer? What the hell? Oh, okay, don't.